Again, a good defensive play by Scurry, and here come the Rebels. Sijanovic. They jump right out on Bice. They're not going to give him that shot. Young in the ball game. He could shoot the three also. Butler on the blocks. Butler follows, keeps the rebound alive, but it comes down to Brown. Here come the Aggies, 4-on-3 in the lane. Henderson had to do something with it, but that wasn't the right something.
Well, he surely didn't make the right play, and fortunately for the Aggies, they didn't lose it on the other end because there was nobody back defensively.
Bad pass by Scurry that time, and a traveling call against Brown. Chris Hickman will come on for the Aggies along with Benjamin. Hill leaves and New leaves.
Good job by Neil McCarthy, rotating his players in and out, trying to make sure he can combat the athletic ability of the Rebels.
Butler, turnaround jumper. Nice shot.
That's all day. That's what they did just all afternoon against San Jose State. You've got to keep the ball out of the middle of any defenses, particularly away from David Butler on the Rebels.
Really an offensive force, Butler. Not the great rebounder, but he sure is a shooter. Reach-in foul is going to be called this time. Young goes to the party. So Scurry sits and Larry Johnson comes back. That'll just give you some idea of the talent that Joe Tarkanian has.
You're reading my mind. I'm listening to this announcer, and I'm watching the game, the PA announcer, and I'm listening to the talent come in. It's like they don't lose anything. They gain with bringing people off the court.
Jordan for three. Way off. Got nothing. Vegas by 7 with the ball.
Now the Aggies have a decision to make. They're trying to extend the defense out a little bit. But if they do, that's what happens. The ball is allowed to get inside because you extend yourself too much defense.
Johnson underneath. Neil McCarthy up, complaining again.
Good active zone here.
You can see the way the Aggies go after the ball, attack the ball. Butler over Hickman, couldn't get it. Follow is up and in. I believe it was Young.
Well, Young will get it. I think it was Jordan that tipped it, but Young will definitely get the credit for it.
9-point Aggie lead. Brown to the basket with a scoop shot.
Can't count them out, Barry. They will attack the basket.
Young, they want to travel, and they might have a good case. Johnson, nice pass underneath, and Butler is hammered. Hickman got it. And Butler got Hickman.
I mean, you're talking about an outstanding pass. Before Larry Johnson comes down, he knows where David Butler is and gets him the ball. Defense did not have a chance to react. That's a foul call. Larry Johnson makes the play because he passed the ball before he came down. Nobody could react to that.
Let's take a good look at Larry Johnson, number 4. We were remarking earlier, here's a guy, looks like he ought to be wearing a number like 53. He's a linebacker, this guy.
Linebacker, he'd be a great tight end.
Look at him. He looks like Lawrence Taylor, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does look like Lawrence Taylor. Did an interview with him. I like him. He's a very affable young man, outgoing, bright kid. And plays very hard. That was one of the questions about him. I have to admit, he had 3 pro scouts looking at it. I'm sure that had something to do with it, though.
Substitution for the Yankees. Rick Plucky replaces Reggie Jordan.
Plucky comes back on. Jordan leaves for Neil McCarthy's New Mexico State Aggies.
Now the Aggies again are in a danger zone. They're down 9 and we have like 5.5 to go. So they need to stay down less than double digits because that's when all of a sudden Las Vegas gets a great deal more confidence too.
Brown forced that shot to drew the foul on Sijanovic. I don't envy the officials working this game, I'll tell you.
No, I don't either. I'm sitting here watching them, and they walked in and listened to this crowd, and they're looking at that. They're watching Las Vegas play. They know they're a very aggressive team. And the emotion in both of these teams, they right now are going for the best record in the conference. So they knew it would be a very well-played, aggressive game.
It's interesting that we mentioned that Vegas has never lost to New Mexico State. They've not only never lost to New Mexico State in basketball, but they've never lost in football either. They're 20-0 against New Mexico State in those two sports. Matter of fact, to take it one step further, they're 29-0 against teams named the Aggies. Brown leaves and Hill comes on, and Brown has been the offense for Neil McCarthy's Aggies so far. They're going to have to find some scoring from someone else. Anderson Hunt. And they will not give him the three, but Young will shoot it two and gets it.
Well, when people come off the bench, you sometimes take them for granted, or you just don't react to them as quickly as you a known starter. It looked as though that might have been a little bit what happened in the favor of Young, but I'm sure there'll be much more attention paid to him the next time back.
Young really.
That was a pro three-pointer there.
Plucky is their designated three-point shooter, so all of a sudden both teams lighten it up. Grab foul going to be called either on Hill or Tice. Hill gets the call as second. Sijanovic leaves and Greg Anthony comes back. He had a pretty long blow, so Vegas is going to be fresh.
They're going to be fresh, and the thing that you have to watch out about, they have law. Vegas does, is when I say they. And they will, as I said, they'll 2, 4, 6 in a row. And then after they get people win, like Anthony's been sitting down, they'll all of a sudden blow at you 12 points and you don't react to it. And you're down, 14, almost 20 points before you know it. And we've got to keep an eye on it right here because the Aggies have to score and hold on the other end. And that's what they're looking at, going down 18 points in a hurry.
Lucky again. And Young right at Hino's face. Benjamin, a little bit of penetration, kicks it out to Hill. And Hill takes the three. And nails it.
Getting out much quicker out to Young now. They know he shoots that 3-point.
Checking right out at him. He still tries it. Won't go. And the rebound bounces around. And he's gone. Interesting, though, Quinn, how Vegas always manages to keep that rebound alive.
Well, they got lively bodies in there. All of those guys they have, Scurry and those kids, they jump and do a lot of good things and keep the ball alive.
3:41 left in the half. UNLV by 6. We'll be back to Las Cruces right after this.
It gives a little rhythm to the Aggies. Now they've got the ball after this timeout. It would be good for them to score here again. And not necessarily on a three-pointer, just score.
3 out of 4, though, from three-point land, and their designated three-point shooter, Plucky, remains in the ballgame. Now he pops out and gets it underneath to Brown. Too hard.
Defense collapsed on him. David Butler had nowhere to go.
Aggies have been packing it in pretty good on defense.
Well, they've got to. As we talked about all game, David Butler is a real force in there, so you have to be concerned. Keep the ball away from Andy Andor. If he gets it, get two people on him, make him pass it.
Flicky threw it away. Turn over the other way. Tough break for the Aggies.
Substitution for the Aggies. Number 2, Reggie Jordan replaces Rick
Flicky. Flicky leaves, and Reggie Jordan comes back.
And as still in that 1-1-3 defense. They play it with one man always on the ball, and they keep three people inside, and then they just try to attack from all over.
Hunt for three won't go. Johnson will follow.
So we were just talking about Larry Johnson at the timeout. He was in the game physically, but we haven't said his name a lot tonight. And still, the Rebels are up 6 points. Gives you some idea of the kind of depth they have.
Hill starts at the baseline. Anthony cuts him off. Got a foul into the process. I want to remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you back to our Bristol studios. John Saunders will bring you up to date on everything that's happened in sports today in the basketball world. Scores, highlights, all the action from all around the country. And your alma mater just before us, a terrific comeback.
You know, I happened to catch a bit of that, and Michigan was beating them rather handedly. And Indiana came back and won the game by two. Great credit to Bob Knight. He's got those freshmen down there, and they're really doing a great job.
That's going to be a good team by the end of the season.
They'll be a very good team by the end of the season. Coach Knight's teams always seem to get better near the latter part of the season, and you have to consider they got freshmen, and they'll learn the ropes by then.
Firstly, the team we're watching right here, pretty darn good team, too. Butler traveled, no call, and a rejection, but a goaltending call against me.
Well, Butler gets the ball in the middle. Again, no defensive transition, and there's no question that the ball is on its downward flight. Fisher makes the good call, but it's the lack of defensive transition that allowed that opportunity for the Rebels.
Butler with 13, and Hill traveled. And that was caused by the good defense.
It's caused by quick feet of Larry Johnson. Got over the end position, and I don't think Keith Hill realized that if somebody 6'7", 250 could move that kick. I didn't.
But Tarkin was up really barking at Tom Harrington. I'm not sure what he was talking about. Tarkin's a guy that doesn't complain very much. Anthony, great acrobatic move. Did everything but make the shot that Stacey Ockman did.
They need a hoop. Aggies need to get a hoop here.
Touch shot by Jordan, got nothing. And here come the Rebels, 2-on-1. Anthony to the basket. And he comes out limping. Might have hit his knee on the post.
Yeah, it looks like that's what it is.
Anderson the other way, too hard. Follow-up try by Jordan, no good. New gets it back, it won't go. Fourth try by Anderson is good.
Well, that's the thing that needs to happen on both ends. If the Aggies want to get in the game, they have to get some offensive rebound baskets. But on the other end of the court, they've got to block out because those are the easy opportunities that you allow the Rebels to get. And the Rebels got a lot of ways to score. You don't want to give them rebound baskets.
Momentary timeout to tend to Greg Anthony, who is still hobbling. I think he might have hit his knee on the standard. Zianovich will replace him.
The defensive pressure is being increased right now. All of a sudden, the Aggies are up with a 2-1-2 trap defense. Just trying to use up a little bit of time here.
Johnson, nice pass for Ockman, but he tried.
That's what they wanted to get out of. They wanted to use some time. If you can get a turnover, get it, but don't reach for the basketball. Stay in good position. That time, Stacey Ockman couldn't make up his mind. Got called for travel.
50 seconds left in the half. Differential of about 11 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock.
Good chance to use up the clock for that.
Try to go back door to Hill. He backs it out. Brown on the lane.
Oh, tough shot. Tough shot. Got it between the defensive players. Cianovich couldn't get up. That was a great shot.
Brown with 17 points, and we should point out his career high, only 21.
Must be what ESPN does to some people then, because he's out showing it out today.
Rebels have played for the last shot. Stacey Ogden can handle it. He's picked from behind. 1 second, they got to get it up in a hurry, they won't do it.
And it came in the first half.
So an up and down first half for both teams, but Vegas was a little bit more up than down, and they lead it by 7. It's 52-45, the UNLV Running Rebels leading the home team for the Mexico State Aggies. Crowd not yet a factor in this game. Right now, let's go to John Saunders. John?